Hello and welcome back to Talent Magnet. This is Doug Foresta. I will be your host for today. And very excited with me is Holly Smith. She is from the Workers' Compensation Determination Unit for L&I. And we're going to be talking about what is an employee. Holly, welcome. Thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. So yes, very excited about this topic. Let's start with Holly. Can you tell our listeners, who is an employee from the perspective of L&I and the requirements for workers' compensation insurance?
So a worker is every person in Washington state who's providing their personal labor for an employer, which includes individuals working under independent contract that does not meet all exemption requirements. For workers' compensation in Washington state, we look at each circumstance to determine if a worker is exempt or not exempt from industrial insurance coverage. Covered workers in Washington state always include employees, family, including minor children, friends, temporary hires, and casual laborers. Covered workers may also include independent contractors, owners, and volunteers.
Thank you. So, all right, so that then begs the question, who is not considered someone who needs to be covered?
So the following individuals would not be considered covered workers: business owners who provide their own labor to their own business, some independent contractors, and some volunteers.
Can you say more about independent contractors?
So coverage for a worker is determined in two steps. Step one is the more than personal labor test, and step two is the independent contractor test. More than personal labor is defined in a three-prong test that shows that the worker must of necessity own or supply machinery or equipment beyond ordinary hand tools to perform the contract, or they obviously couldn't complete the contract without assistance, or they employ others to do all or part of the contracted work. The independent contractor test consists of the following requirements. To be an exempt independent contractor, an individual must first be free from direction and control, and second, either perform a service which is outside the course of the business that hired them, or perform a service away from all of the business locations, or be responsible both under contract and in fact for the costs of their own principal place of business. And third, either have an existing business in which they provide the same services to other clients, or have a principal place of business that qualifies for the IRS business deduction. And fourth, they're required to file a business tax return with the IRS. And fifth, have an active account and UBI number with the Department of Revenue. And sixth, maintain their own set of books and records that show all items of income and expenses. Additionally, for construction trades, the individual must have a valid contractor registration that's applicable to the type of work that they're performing. There are some resources available to help business owners make the distinction between covered workers and independent contractors. The Workers' Compensation Determinations Unit can assist business owners with questions related to workers' compensation and provide a written determination pertaining to specific workers. You can reach us through email at determinations@lni.wa.gov. Also, anyone can access the Labor and Industries website at www.lni.wa.gov. to verify independent contractors as well as obtain additional information pertaining to workers' compensation.
Thank you. So, all right, so I'm understanding that a for-profit business can't have volunteers, that the people working for a business must be covered for workers' compensation insurance and other worker protections, but nonprofit organizations can have volunteers. Is that right?
In a sense, yes. That's while for-profit businesses are presumed not to have volunteers, there are some exceptions, including student volunteers and unpaid students, as well as limited circumstances such as emergencies that would be considered on a case-by-case basis. For-profit businesses who are considering engaging volunteers for any reason should check with L&I prior to bringing them on board.
So, all right, thank you, Holly. So I'm understanding that a for-profit business can't have volunteers, that the people working for a business must be covered by workers' compensation insurance and other worker protections, but nonprofit organizations can have volunteers. So part A question is, what determines if a person working for a nonprofit organization can be considered a volunteer, or if that individual must be considered an employee? And then B, what if a volunteer meets the volunteer definition, but the organization for liability reasons wants them to have workers' comp coverage? Is that a possibility? And is it the same cost as for non-volunteers?
So while for-profit businesses are presumed not to have volunteers, there are some exceptions, including student volunteers and unpaid students, as well as limited circumstances such as emergencies that are considered on a case-by-case basis. For-profit businesses who are considering engaging volunteers for any reason should check with L&I prior to bringing them on board. A volunteer is a person who donates labor by their own free choice without receiving material or monetary or other value in exchange. The business or organization may provide the volunteer with maintenance and reimbursement for actual expenses that are necessarily incurred. However, anything of value beyond expenses could make the individual a covered worker. If the individual meets the definition of a volunteer for L&I purposes, in a few cases, they may be able to obtain workers' compensation coverage for the hours that they work. This coverage would be for medical expenses only. Workers' compensation coverage is available for volunteers of private nonprofit charities. However, workers' compensation coverage is not available for volunteers of nonprofit organizations that are non-charitable or for-profit businesses, except for qualifying students and unpaid students. Coverage falls under one of two risk classifications specifically designed for volunteers. Employers would not report volunteer hours under their general business classification, but the volunteer classification that is applicable to the type of volunteer they employ, a student or a non-student.
Thank you. All right, so what about interns? Can employers get coverage for them?
So businesses who employ interns who meet the qualifications as an unpaid student are not required to, but can obtain workers' compensation for those individuals.
All right, so what else? I mean, you've given us a lot of information here. What else should businesses and nonprofits be aware of?
So L&I receives referrals or complaints about businesses from a variety of sources. Business owners should practice due diligence when hiring independent contractors and volunteers, as well as when reporting quarterly hours to L&I. And this can help avoid audits or other issues with their industrial insurance account. L&I has multiple resources for business owners available on our website, www.lni.wa.gov. Here, you can click to find information pertaining to independent contractors, volunteers, reporting requirements, record-keeping requirements, and other information pertaining to workers' compensation. Additionally, you can find forums and publications for a variety of topics that are designed to assist business owners with questions about workers' compensation. And we know this information can be confusing, so I do appreciate the opportunity to talk with you. And in addition to following up with the resources I've described, people are welcome to contact me or L&I's Small Business Office with additional questions.
Holly, thank you so much. Thanks for sharing your words of wisdom on this complex topic. I really appreciate it. Thanks for joining me on Talent Magnet.
Thank you.